we should find out whether, if you're carrying these man bags, you should have a health warning, because it's not just men that suffer. Chiropractors claim that over-the-shoulder satchels, messenger bags, handbags are all causing damage. And we've got Dr. Adam Smith, the world-famous economist. Adam, how are you?
Very well, thank you, Fred. How fed up are you with that?
Man bags are a relatively new phenomenon, being called that, and they do tend to cause some damage to the delicate nerves in the shoulders and the neck. So, as a chiropractor, we do see a rising number of people complaining of neck and shoulder pain, oftentimes due to wearing a bag over one shoulder.
Now, Adam, I, for many years, was on the road as a stand-up comedian, and I can remember slinging a bag over my shoulder and heading out of the house. Always had it over my right shoulder. But these days, it's my left shoulder that gives me problems. Will that be related?
It could possibly be. Most people try and think back through their lives, or even through the last couple of days, when they notice a pain for one particular thing that's caused one particular pain. And this is not always a useful way to think. As a chiropractor, we look at the body as a whole, and we look at the whole past history and everything that you've done or even not done that can contribute to aches and pains. So you're wearing your bag over your right shoulder will have contributed. Was it the only thing? Possibly not.
Right. And can you tell, just by looking at somebody, the way they stand with or without a bag, whether they've got problems?
Yes, definitely. My wife has actually banned me from commenting on people's posture in shopping centres and things now. It's a useful hobby of the chiropractic profession to look at the way people walk or the way they carry themselves to look and see how their spine is being affected. Because posture is a window to how the spine functions.
Now, in the past, a briefcase would just have had a handle and somebody would have carried it like they would a suitcase, for example. But now they pretty much all come with a shoulder strap as well. Has that been a step backwards?
Possibly, but I mean, when you look back right the way back to when the Scottish invented the man bag in the first place, otherwise known as the sporran, it wasn't carried over the shoulder, it was carried around the waist. So that's a much more effective distribution of weight. One of the biggest things that I tell all of my patients is when they're carrying any load, the more places that you can distribute that load, the better. So, for example, if you're wearing a backpack, you're carrying it over both shoulders, and if you wear a waist strap as well, this allows you to carry more weight more comfortably.
Yeah, and you know, going way back even further, Adam, to school days, you know, a school satchel, which should have been worn with two straps, but I guess just about all of my school days, you just slung it over one shoulder.
Yeah, that's correct, because it's seriously uncool to wear both straps over your shoulders, and especially if it's got a waist strap and a chest strap, that's just caused to be stuffed into a locker and beaten up. So most school kids that I see, when I do workshops with teachers in the schools themselves, we talk about exercises that are useful for the children to improve their posture, but also the best way to carry the bag. And unfortunately, the best way to carry the bag is the uncool way.
How's Mackenzie sitting today, Adam?
She's doing much better than last time. I remember last time we were in here and we had some difficulty with the headphone cord when we were checking the posture, so we're going to be doing that again today. No, she's doing just fine. One of your producers mentioned that you do carry a bag, Fred. What bag have you got?
excuse me. It's just a briefcase, but just as I described, with a shoulder. And it's not that heavy. excuse me. But you know, I'm just thinking not just so much that bag, but I've got bags if I'm travelling. Sports-wise, I've got my, you know, golf bags as well.
Of course.
They have changed over the years, Adam. You now get a sort of double strap for golf bags.
And that makes perfect sense, because a golf bag is quite heavy, and you're carrying it for an extended period of time. The main problem comes when you're carrying any bag for a long period of time, and this is where the damage can build up over the years. Especially people like tradesmen or someone who has to carry something in a particular way, you can develop scar tissue around the delicate nerves in the shoulder. And those nerves go down into your arm and they control your arm movement. They also go to internal organs as well. So the levels of damage can build up over a long period of time.
And when I first started travelling, Adam, most people would have had a bag over their shoulder or be carrying a suitcase. There were very few wheeled cases, but now, if you go through an airport, just about everyone has got a wheeled bag of some size. But even them, I reckon, you're kind of twisted round pulling them along.
Yes, you often are. You are turning and pulling the bag along most times. what I tend to recommend for people, obviously, is minimize the weight as much as you can in any of the bags.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, when I was asked to come on, I had to think and come up with the three M's for man bagging.
Here we
go. And the three M's I've come up with are minimize the weight.
Mm-hmm.
So obviously, the smaller the bag, the better. The next one is maintain the distribution. So make sure that you keep the heaviest stuff closest to your body. You don't want to be packing the heavy laptop as the furthest thing out in the bag.
Yeah.
You want your clothes
close,
or...
Keep that close.
Yeah, keep that close to your back. It distributes the weight better.
Yep.
And the other end?
And the other end is mix it up, as you were saying. Swap shoulders. Wear it on your left shoulder in the morning, the right shoulder in the afternoon, both shoulders if you can. And this helps to maintain your body's even weight distribution. And the better you can do that, the better your health.
Adam, many thanks for that. We're coming up to the news, but I can tell the listeners that your posture improving exercises are going to be put up on our website, bbc.co.uk/Radio Scotland, and click on today's Macaulay & Co. programme page. Thanks a lot, Adam.
Thank you very much, Fred.